Many of us are also involved in drugs. Drugs. Carrying drugs here and there. Trading in drugs here and there. If not, even smoking it. Amen. But I want us to know that drugs can kill those using it. A lot of people are dead today. People who were taking this, they died as a result of this drug. And you are the one trading in it. God said, I should ask you, where
are you?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you, one, I used to know one in Nigeria those days, because it's from my area. He was a baron. He was sending a lot of people abroad to go and sell drugs. And many were arrested. Many were even killed. They were arrested in these countries where they killed drug pushers. Amen.
Amen.
They were arrested and they killed. You know what we would do? We just go and meet the wife, give them some money and say, don't worry, that's not fine. Give his wife big money and take her pictures. He would give them peanuts. A time came, there was a big problem. All of them were coming to, our husband is no more. The children are suffering. The money you gave us is not enough. We need money. Become a big problem. Hallelujah. And some of them started running. That could relocate out of Lagos or want to stay in a very hidden place that nobody can know where he is. But you see the kind of life was not there. You are driving and looking left and right to see if anybody, somebody does the crossing, you know, you're teasing and you, they don't come in. Why? Because we have soiled our hands. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us desist from all this. These things are not good. In as long as we are also having children, our children, so that our children will not also suffer the same thing we are doing to other people's children, we should desist from trouble. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We must desist from them so that God will be happy with us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Idolatry. The God I serve said, I am a jealous God. God is so jealous. He said, I'm a God and I'm a jealous God. Amen. Today, many of us, yes, we come to church. Sometimes I wonder why Nigerians, every Sunday morning, the whole church is filled. And yet, there is a lot of sin in Nigeria. I'm sorry for those who are not from Nigeria. Yeah, I'm using Nigeria because that's where I come from and that's where I really know. I really don't know about the country. But I want you to know that Sunday morning, the church is filled. On Monday morning, sin, destruction here and there. Most of these same people who were in the church on Sunday morning, they are in the market collecting money from, madam, where are these things? You know what I mean? Carry everything. Pour it away. Hallelujah. Monday morning, they will stand in front of the taxi driver. Give me your money. Now say this thing. They will remove the side mirror. Baka! Draw him out of the bus. This is somebody who was in the church on Sunday morning. Say, praise the Lord! These same people. Hallelujah. This is what we are seeing. Many of us, we serve idols. Many of us, we are in the church on Sunday, but when we are just to remove our clothes, something is tied on our waist. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. My grandmother gave me this thing, he said I must not remove it. My grandfather gave me this thing, he said I must not remove it. You are an idolater. Hallelujah. You are an idolater. You claim to know God, you claim to be serving God, and yet you are still carrying something given to you by your grandmother and your grandmother. God says, I tell you, where are
you?
Amen, somebody.
Yes.
Where are you? What are you doing to yourself? God is a consuming fire. He is a jealous God. He knows everything we are doing. There's nothing that can be hidden from Him. I want you to open your eyes to Exodus chapter 20, verse 5. Somebody else, you open Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 24. And the last person will open Exodus 34, verse 14. Exodus 20, verse 5. Deuteronomy 4, 24. Exodus 34, verse 14. Hallelujah. If we are there, I want to hear your ear.
Yeah.
Exodus 20, verse 5. Can somebody read for us?
Amen.
Amen.
So you shall not bow down to them nor serve them. For I, the Lord your God, I am a jealous God.
Go ahead.
Visiting the iniquities of the father upon the children to the third and fourth generation.
Hallelujah. It's okay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, you should not bow down to them or serve them. Many of us today are serving money. Many of us today are serving our husband. Many of us today are serving our wives. Amen. You are an idolator. If our husband does not say go to the church, you will not go. My husband never talk. He never say make I go. I know they go. I don't want problem. You are an idolator. My wife saying tired today, no fit go church. Therefore, me and no fit come church. You are an idolator. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And God said, I am a jealous God. I visit the iniquities of the father upon who? You want your children to live well? Desist from what you are doing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us also read Deuteronomy 4:24. Amen.
For the Lord your God is a consuming fire.
For the Lord your God is a consuming fire.
A jealous God.
A jealous God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord your God is a jealous God. He's a consuming fire. This is the same God who said, whatever, Father, have mercy. Man, he's a merciful God. Yes, yes. We continue to do what we do because we believe he's merciful. But the Bible is telling us here in Deuteronomy chapter 4. That the Lord our God is a consuming fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is to say, the day he will send his fire to consume sinners, if you are among the sinners, no matter how your prayers, no matter how your prayers for mercy, if you are among the sinners that's to be consumed that day, you will consume. That will not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let somebody read Exodus 34, verse 14 also.
Do not worship any other God.
Do not worship any other God.
Because I, the Lord your God, is what?
Because I, the Lord your God, is what?
Tolerate no rivals.
That is to say, I am jealous. Many of us, We have other gods. Many of us, up to today, our parents are still sending us this. Say, make sure you bath with this one. Make sure after your bath, after bathing, rub this one on your face. And go to the prefecture. Hallelujah. Rub off your face, then you go there. We will know who is who. Hallelujah. Say, the moment Oyibo man see you, if you smile, say, give you everything what you want. Don't try him. You'll find yourself in Nigeria or Africa. That will not be a portion in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because they do not believe in it and it does not work. You see, it's only what you believe in that will work. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So do not allow anyone to deceive you. And let me tell you, if peradventure something happened, you say, oh, let me do another thing when I bring up for you, daddy, then because no way. Even without that listening, this would have still happened because God has destined that it will happen. Nothing comes by accident, nothing happens by accident. God has seen your beginning. God has seen your end from the beginning, and God has seen your beginning from the end. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Idolatry. Many of us are idolaters today. Sundays we are here. Many are even leaders in the church. There are so many in Nigeria. They are deacons and deaconesses. Elders. But on Monday morning, they are going to carry their 13-year-old daughter and meet a madam and say, please help me carry and go abroad. Knowing fully well that girl, those don't know how to do hair. Maybe at the first 10 years, when he gets here, he will start to do hair. He'll be working in the salon. Have you taught her? Have you sent her to go and learn how to do hair? Before you are taking her to meet that madam to come and carry her abroad. On Sunday morning, you go and sit there in front of the church as a deacon and as a deaconess. Hallelujah. Brethren, God is watching us. And God is angry over what is going on. God is angry over what is going on. You see all of them trying to gather here and there. And when their daughter gets here and say, Papa, Mama, not be waiting with us for that side, not be at the CEO. They say I should go and be doing prostitution. They say, my begin, I beg, make you know, just do it. Pay them fee. You, father, you, mother, that is doing that to your child, the God I serve will strike you.
Amen.
You have a right to bring that child to earth, but you don't have a right to kill that child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You send your children to slavery. Look at the streets today. In those days, we still see matured ladies on the street. Today, they are more and more getting little and little and little. 10 years, very soon, we'll begin to see that. Some came to my shop one day. I was just looking at them and said, I folded my arms like this. When they were buying things, I never even uttered one word because I was crying within me. And look at what they want. Thank God for hot sun. You will know that these ones, they started having menstrual pains when they came here. Because According to them, they said they asked some men to come and help them to open their whatever, so that they can do the work they want them to do. Hallelujah. The God I serve will strike our parents who are pushing our daughters to go and do this. In the name of Jesus. Many are watching me. Many will still hear more. Because I am coming for you. I am coming after you. The God I serve, the way Elijah called down fire to consume that God of Baal. The same way I'm going to call down fire. The God I serve will strike every father, every mother that encourages their daughter to prostitute in the name of Jesus. Yeah. They are bringing disgrace. They are bringing disgrace. Not only to themselves, even to the nation called Nigeria. The president, the wife, when they were campaigning, they visited Benin. The only thing that woman can talk about Benin is prostitution. Why? Because, yes, she has right to do so. Even though many people were castigating her, everybody started, blah, 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 blah. But she has said the truth. She has said the truth. She said the Benins are soiling the name of Nigeria. And if her husband becomes a president, she will fight everything to make sure to stop human trafficking and prostitution. And people were saying all sorts of nonsense against her. Why are we so wicked? Why are we so wicked? So you people are happy that the Benins are involved in this, and you are happy for that? And now you are castigating her? Now you are insulting her? Well, thank God the husband is there now. We are waiting to see what they will do to stop this. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are waiting to see what they will do to stop this. Because God is not happy over what we are doing today. In that same Leviticus chapter 19, the Bible told us, he said, if you send your children to prostitution, say, I will visit your land with wickedness. There's wickedness all around us in that country today because our people have sold their children into prostitution. I don't know what kind of money they want to make. I don't know the kind of house they want to build. The worst part, most of them are not even building houses with the money. Every party that is going on, they will make them chairman, chairlady in the party. And they will ask that their children will send money, they will put oil in their bags, and they go there and begin to throw money. Throw money. Like these fraud stars, their latest one now is to spread the money on the air. Everything will begin to shake. The heap of money will be as high as this. Fraud stars. Can you work hard for your money and do that to your money? Hallelujah. Tell somebody God is watching. Every day for the thief. One day for the owner. Praise the Lord. One day for the owner. God is watching. They will suffer for what they are doing. No wonder many of them, they even started suffering. No peace. No husband. Hallelujah. You see, these young boys, we just go to them and say, don't worry, I'm looking for a wife. I'm not looking for a girlfriend. You know, they know what you want. They will tell you what you want. So I'm looking for a wife. I'm not looking for a girlfriend. Ah, you say, man, I don't see a young boy when I'm married. She said, okay, don't worry. I will start. I will touch you up. 10K. Give the guy 10K. 10K that one small girl have suffered all her body to walk and give to you. You carry it and give it to one young boy. One came to me one day and said, Pastor, help me pray. This boy, that 10,000, make me bring and come back to me. I said, I did that when you give her the 10,000. Before you gave the guy the 10,000, something. If you call God, is God aware of it? So don't ever come to me for such kind of prayers. I don't pray such kind of prayers. That was the last day I've seen that here. I'm not right there. Hallelujah. I think they say the boy is using the money now to do. He believes Zakarabu. That is to say he's enjoying himself in Belgium with different guests with 10K. If not you come. Somebody just carry 10K. Land for your hand. You don't work for it. What do you go think I'm doing? Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes. The sin they are committing, they are going to survive. Peace they will not have. They will not have peace. They will not have good health. Many of them are suffering. You see them when they are doing party, you see when they will wear different things. Hey, mama, the mama, put her for high table. Bam. When they finish that party, they go, all this my body just the pain. It go pain you. Because the people you are suffering on that street, their blood is on your head. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, brethren, God is asking us, where are you? You know yourself. I know myself. You know if you are sinning. You know if you are walking right. Amen.
Amen.
So, the question is up to you. What is your response? Are you in the right place or in the wrong place? If in the right place, praise God. But if in the wrong place, you still have the opportunity to move out from that wrong place and move into the right place. Walk in the light and move out of that darkness. And as you do this, I am assuring you, the good Lord will bless and honor you in Jesus' name. Praising the Lord always, praising thy Lord. God is asking each and every one of us, where are we? Are we in the right place? Are we all, we are in the wrong place? It is there for us to answer before God, because a time will come where He's no longer asking us but judging us. I want to talk to God this morning. You are in the right place. Ask God to help you to continue to the end. Never to fall aside. And if you are in the wrong place, ask God for forgiveness. Ask Him to help you change from your ways. Because it is not by power, neither is it by might, but by His grace. Pray in the name of Jesus. Knowing fully well that our God is a consuming fire. Knowing fully well that our God is a jealous God. He said He will vent the sin of the father upon the children. All to the fourth generation. If you do not want your children to suffer, over your sin, pray for forgiveness. Pray for forgiveness. Christ. Live right. And ask Him to help you stand upright.
Let's put hands together for our Lord Jesus. Put hands together